Good afternoon, dear colleagues and my dear students. This is Vikram Reddy, working as school assistant arts in ZPSS Kusmanchi, Khammam district. We are discussing about the lesson atmosphere. So in that in the previous class we discussed about the important topic structure of the atmosphere. In that lesson we discussed about what are the important layers of the atmosphere and what are the different gases existed in the atmosphere. Today we shall discuss about what is pressure and pressure belts. So we shall get into the topic. So what is air pressure? As we discussed that the atmospheric air is composed of different gases. As we know, the air in atmosphere is composed of gas molecules. So these gas molecules existed in the air will move from one place to another place. In that process, these gas molecules push each other, or sometimes these all gas molecules push any other object that which come in their way. So with this push effect, the gas molecules move from one place to another place. In the process of push effect, if they push to any other object, the process is called as air pressure. Means simply air put some force on other object, that is called as air pressure. This air pressure, the molecules, the gas molecules in the air, they won't apply from one specific side. As we know, air move freely from different directions. So air apply pressure on different objects from all the sides. Next, this pressure, the air pressure increases and decreases. When the air pressure increase or when the air pressure decrease, when more molecules present in a specific area, means if in a specific area in the air, if it consists of more gas molecules, then the pressure increases. If the gas molecules in the air are less in a specific area, then the pressure decreases. Means increasing or decreasing of air pressure is depend upon different factors. Generally, air pressure is more near the surface of the earth. As we know, earth has one characteristic, that is earth's gravitational pull. As earth has gravitation force, earth pulls most of the gas molecules in the air to its surface. So that's why air pressure is more near the earth surface. So this is one phenomena. Next, how the air moves in different directions. So when earth surface is heated, the air above its surface also heats up. As we know, earth will get solar radiation. The process is called as insolation. The earth surface will heats up first. Afterwards, the air above the earth surface will heats up. So in that process, after the after earth surface is heated, then next the air above the earth surface will also heats up. Whenever the earth surface heats up, the gas molecules that existed in the air, they get a lot of energy with this heat. So due to that energy, the gas molecules start moving very fast from one place to another place. As their energy is more, these gas molecules start flying as they have lighter. Generally, the heat, due to the heat, the molecules will become lighter and lighter. So with that light weight, the gas molecules will fly higher and higher altitudes, higher places. So automatically, if the more number of molecules fly to higher places, only less number of molecules will retain on the Earth's surface. So if the less number of molecules retain on Earth's surface, that is called as low pressure area, means the pressure will be less. We already discussed that when the gas molecules are less, their push effect will be also less. So automatically pressure will be also less. If the gas molecules are more in a specific area, the push effect will be more. So automatically pressure will be more. So in that process, due to the more temperature, due to the heating of Earth's surface, it creates low pressure near the Earth's surface area. So we can say that the pressure will be less in the areas where the temperatures are very high. So that we can conclude. If the air gets hot, pressure becomes low. When it becomes, if the air becomes cool, the pressure will be increases. Simply, we can conclude that the temperature and the pressure has inverse relationship. That means, if the temperature is more or if the temperatures are high, automatically pressure will be low. If the temperatures, if the air cools down, the temperatures will be very low. At that particular area, the pressure increases. So we can say that the temperatures and pressure has inverse relationship. This is one principle. Next, if the heated air rises, it starts losing energy. As it go distant from the Earth's surface, automatically after it going to higher places, the gas molecules will lose their energy. And again, when they are far from the Earth's surface. So after going higher places, these gas molecules will slow down due to the less energy or due to the losing of energy. And they get closer to each other. Simple thing you should remember that when the gas molecules lost their energy, they come to closer. When they got more energy, they move freely and fastly to the different places. Means they occupy vast area. So when the molecules, when their energy slow down, when they got less energy, they come close to the each other. So at that particular time, as we go upwards, as we already discussed, air becomes cooler. So automatically molecules will come near. That is called as air become denser. So automatically the air falls towards the Earth's surface. As it got more weight, the gas molecules fall towards the Earth surface. So we can observe in this area. See, here near the Earth surface, there are more gas molecules. If as the Earth surface got heats up, automatically the atmosphere above the Earth surface will also heats up. So generally the gas molecules will become light and get more energy and they fly towards higher places. See, the gas molecules with the light weight, they are moving higher places. Means before moving higher places, the gas molecules occupied more area, because as the heat temperature is more here, the gas molecules existed in vast area. So as they has light weight, they move towards upwards. As we know, as per the normal lapse rate, when we are going upwards higher altitudes in tropic troposphere, the temperatures will be decreases. At one certain height, due to the decrease in temperatures, so these gas molecules will also lose their energy. Due to their they regain their weight and they come nearer. So automatically, when they come nearer, here these molecules came to near, and here a vacuum was established, means only less gas molecules are existed at the distant places. So this led to formation of low pressure area. When there are less gas molecules at distant places, this leads to the low pressure area, because their push effect will be less in this particular area. Next, here these gas molecules came to nearer, and they are at close places. So this leads to the formation of high pressure area. When near the earth surface, this led to the formation of low pressure area. At the higher places, it led to the formation of high pressure area. So here we can observe more vacant area. Here the gas molecules came to close each other. So due to the more vacant space and less molecules exist, that led to the low pressure area near the earth surface. And high pressure area, molecules moves towards the vacant place, if you observe once again. So here the high pressure area formed. To fill this vacant place, these molecules will try to reach the earth surface. So another principle, the air always flows from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. Generally, the nature of the gas molecules in the air, that they move towards the vacant place. Where we can find vacant place? Where the gas molecules are very less. Where we can find out less molecules? Where the pressure is less, we can find out more vacant place. Molecules from the high pressure area, molecules move towards the less pressure areas. So a principle, it is that the nature of the air got that air always flows from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. So as per that nature, air moves from different areas of the world, that is on the surface of the earth, it forms different pressure belts. We can observe them. Another nature, different areas on the earth has different natures. Earth surface does not heat uniformly. Temperatures are different from one area to another area. So we can say that earth does not heat uniformly. As we know, temperatures will be more near the equator, and the temperatures will be very less near the pole regions. And another nature is that the land part, the intercontinental part, heats up faster and cools faster. That is the nature of the land part, because the land part attracts temperature, so automatically it heats up faster and it cools down faster. Whereas opposite to land part, the water part, like oceans and the seas, they heats up, water part heats up slowly and cools down slowly. So automatically, the temperature, the when the land part heats up faster, the temperatures will be more. When the water part heats up slowly, the temperatures will be less. So automatically, we can conclude that there are variations in the distribution of temperature throughout the world. So automatically, pressure also. As we know, temperature and pressure are inverse relationship. The pressure will be more where the temperature is less. The pressure will be less where the temperature is more. So whenever the temperature is different from one place to another place, automatically pressure will be also different from one place to another place. If you observe the distribution of temperature, here this is equator line, and this is Tropic of Cancer, and this is Tropic of Capricorn. If you observe, sun rays falls directly on the tropical region, means in between Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn. The area is called as a tropical zone. This particular area faces directly to the sun. So automatically sun rays directly falls and straightly on the tropical zone. So this tropical latitudes, means the latitudes in between Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, they receive intense amount of solar radiation, means they receive more solar radiation. So comparatively, the temperate zones, means Tropic of Cancer to Arctic Circle, Tropic of Capricorn to Antarctic Circle, these tropical temperate zones. Next, cool zones, this is Arctic Circle to North Pole, Antarctic Circle to South Pole. These two areas in north side and these two areas in the south side, they get only less amount of solar radiation when compared with the tropical zone. So automatically we can say that the temperatures are more in tropical areas when compared with the temperate zone or polar zone. So means we can say that the temperatures, distribution of temperature is not even on the surface of the earth. So pressure is depend upon the temperature. So temperature will be low near the tropical zone. As temperatures are very high, pressure will be low. Here in the polar zone, temperatures are very less. So automatically pressure will be more. So as we already discussed, the air always moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. Why? Why air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area? In low pressure area consists of less gas molecules. So high pressure area consists of more gas molecules, and their push effect will be also more. So gas molecules in the high pressure area will always try to occupy the vacant place in the low pressure area. So in that process, air moves from high pressure areas to low pressure area. The movement of air from high pressure area to low pressure area is called wind. So wind means movement of air from specific direction, that is called wind. But wind blows in with a different intensity. If wind moves at a slow pace and slowly, it is called as a breeze. If the wind comes in a short and fast burst, in fastly, it moves fastly, it is called as gust. If it is moves very fast and blows around with maximum speed, the movement is called as storm. Means as per the speed of air from one specific area to another specific area, that is called with different names. General movement of air is called as wind. If the movement is slow, it is called as breeze. If it is short and fast, it is called gust. Next, it is very fast and blows, it is called storm. So as we discussed, winds constantly move one place to another place on the surface of the earth. So we discussed just now, temperatures at equator are more. So So automatically the more temperatures creates low pressure areas. So in generally we can specify that this is called as the area in between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. This is called as tropical zone. Here this is called as tropical low pressure belt. This is called as equatorial low pressure belt, means the area surrounding the equatorial zone is called as equatorial low pressure belt. It is also called as intertropical convergence zone, means the area in between the tropics. So that's why it is called as intertropical convergence zone. Next, as we discussed that the low pressure air due to high temperatures, gas molecules will get more energy. So with that energy, the molecules will rises. So like that, the air at equator will also rises. And after rising, after reaching higher places, it won't stay at a specific place. As it has the air molecules has light weight, they spread towards north and south, towards different areas. So at the higher places, the temperatures will be less. It is called as the normal lapse rate. We already discussed in the last class. So at the lower temperatures, the air cools down. So means when the air cools down, automatically the gas molecules will lose their energy and they come near places. So their weight will increase. So the cool air consists of weighing gas molecules. They will come back to the earth again. So this is the another phenomena. So if you observe on the basis of this movement of the air from one area to another area on the basis of pressure, the pressure different pressure belts are formed. Basically there are four pressure belts. First one is equatorial low pressure belt, means the areas in between the Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, this is called as equatorial pressure belt. This is low pressure because the temperatures are very high. So this is low pressure belt. So the area is equatorial area. So this is called as equatorial low pressure belt. Next one is subtropical high pressure belt, means generally the area outside the tropics here and these areas are called as subtropics. The area outside the tropics is called as subtropics. Here the temperatures are comparatively less when compared with the tropical zone. So this leads to the formation of high pressure area. High pressure area when compared with the tropical zone. So this is called as high pressure belt here south side and here in the north side. So the area is called as subtropic area. So and it led to formation of high pressure belt. So it is called as subtropical high pressure belt in north side, subtropical high pressure belt in the south side. Next one, subpolar area. Subpolar area means the area around the 66.5 degrees north latitude and the area surrounding the 66.5 degrees south latitudes. Here the pressure will be low when compared with the poles. When compared with the north pole and south pole, the pressure will be less. So automatically it leads to the formation of low pressure belt. In not compare with the subtropical region, compare with the polar region, the temperatures will be less near 66.5 degrees areas. So that leads to the formation of low pressure belt. It is called as subpolar low pressure belt. Here near the 66.5 degrees, here near the 66.5 degrees. Next, polar high pressure belt means the area near the 90 degrees north, the area near the 90 degrees south. There the temperatures will be very less. So when the temperatures are very less, the pressure will be very high. So this leads to the formation of high pressure belt. So this is called as polar high pressure belts. So basically the surface of the earth is on the basis of temperature, it is divided into four important pressure belts. If you observe how the air moves from different areas, see, this is equator. If you imagine this is a area, equatorial area, there the temperatures are very high. It leads to the hot winds. So generally it leads to the low pressure area, low pressure belt. Equatorial area is also called as low pressure belt. So this low pressure area consists of lighter gas molecules, and they move towards upwards. The gas molecules move towards upwards. After reaching higher places, they due to their light weight, they move towards either north or south in that way. After reaching higher places, the air cools down, and the cool air due to their weight, again they reaches the earth surface in that way. Here the area is a subtropical high pressure area. So generally, as we know the principle that the air always blow from the high pressure area to low pressure area, here from here to equatorial low pressure area, next from here to subpolar low pressure area. Next, the air near the low pressure area, due to their light weight, they try to reach as higher places, and they spread it into different north and south areas. Here the after reaching higher places, the air cools down, and it try to reaches the earth surface. And after reaching, the air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area, and high pressure area to another low pressure area. The same phenomena will take place in north side and south side also, in the both areas. So one thing, air always moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. The low pressure area air, due to its light weight, it move towards higher areas, and there it divided into different areas. After getting cooled down, due to its weight, again it reaches the earth surface. This is a circular format. The air always blow in the different areas in that way. If you observe, this is the movement of air on the earth surface. But if you take, the air has to move in a straight direction. Suppose if you take the air should blow in this direction, but it changed its direction. Here also it has to blow in this particular direction, but it changed direction in this way. Why? What is the reason for the slight diversion of air different areas? So this is a phenomena that is called as effect called as Coriolis effect. Due to the Coriolis effect, air will not move in a straight line. They divert their angle. So that is called as Coriolis effect. The theory was proposed by a French scientist, Gaspard Gustave de Coriolis. So that's why the effect is called as Coriolis effect. What is meant by Coriolis effect? Generally, this is equatorial line. We expect wind moves in a straight line. As we know, wind or air moves from high pressure area to low pressure area. But we expect that wind moves in a straight line from the north to south or south to north. We can expect that air moves in that straight line. We expect this in this way. But winds on the earth surface move slightly to the right direction in the northern hemisphere, and towards left side in the southern hemisphere. The winds move slightly to the either to the right or to the left. Why this happens, this effect happens? As we know, Earth rotate on its own axis around itself, from west to east in the anti-clockwise direction. While moving, when air starts here, if Earth moves towards west, automatically air blows in this direction. So near the equatorial line, the effect, Coriolis effect, will be zero, but the movement is more near the poles. As we know, movement of the Earth is more near the far from the equatorial line, so automatically air direction will change towards the right, the hemisphere, northern hemisphere, and the direction slightly changes towards the left in the southern hemisphere. Actually, the Coriolis effect is zero near the equatorial line, but it will be maximum, the effect will be maximum near the pole areas. See, if you observe, Earth rotates from east to west here and west to east. So when Earth moves this side, so automatically air which started here will reach this place. How this will happen? I will show you a video. See, if you imagine this as Earth, if Earth is not moving, automatically the air blows straightly. If the Earth is not moving, so when Earth is moving, if air starts, it won't reaches the straight line. See, due to the movement, the air reaches some other place. See, direction changing due to the movement. See that direction. So this is called as Coriolis effect. So due to this particular Coriolis effect, due to the movement of the Earth, the air started from the equator reaches some other place instead of moving in a straight direction. Due to this Earth movement, it reaches somewhere by making slight tilt towards left in the northern hemisphere, slight tilt towards right in the northern direction, northern hemisphere, left in the southern hemisphere. This is called as Coriolis effect. Due to this Coriolis effect, the winds won't blow in a straight direction. They will change their direction in the areas, angle. See, the angle changes in different areas and different pressure belts. So this is the pressure belts and the angle of winds, that is Coriolis effect. The winds play important role in the weather and climate pattern. As you know, the winds blow from equatorial region. Generally, they transport hot air. The winds that blow from polar regions, they transport cool air. So hot air will increase the temperatures in some areas. The cool air transported by the wind may decrease the temperatures in some areas. Means we can say that the winds influence the temperatures of specific areas. Next, in the history also, the winds helped trade and commerce in the ancient days, particularly in the medieval ages or starting of the modern ages, when the capacity of the engine, ship engine, was not more, they used the trade people, the trade people used winds to move from one area to another area. For example, if you take Vasco da Gama, who invented the sea route to India, he was able to reach India for trade using trade winds. As you know, from Cape of Good Hope to he reaches Calicut. So we can also observe local variations in the wind pattern also. If you see, for example, if you take Visakhapatnam, Visakhapatnam is on the sea shores. So sea wind will blow towards the land area of Visakhapatnam. So cool breeze from the sea influence the temperatures of Visakhapatnam. So the temperatures will be comparatively less when compared with the continental areas. So the winds will influence the weather conditions and climate patterns of some areas. The winds are influencing the trade and commerce throughout the world, and the winds are influencing the local temperatures. They are showing the variations in the wind patterns. So this is about the air pressure and the pressure belts and the Coriolis effect. We discussed these things, and the advantages of winds also we discussed in this particular topic. So try to recapitulate what we learnt today. What is air pressure? The push effect of air on the different objects is called as air pressure. Explain about high pressure and low pressure. If the temperatures are high at a particular place, the gas molecules will become lighter and they move upwards. And the molecules will be very less in that particular area, that leads to the low pressure. If in an area the temperatures are less, the molecules will come nearer and denser, and that leads to the formation of high pressure area. What are the pressure belts? On the basis of distribution of temperature, the pressure belts formed. Basically, there are four pressure belts. Define wind, breeze, gust, and storm. The movement of air in different ways called with different names. The movement of air from one specific area to another specific area is called as wind. If the flow of air is slow, it is called as breeze. If it is sudden, it is called as gust. If it is fast and more, it is called as storm. What is ITCZ, intertropical convergent zone? That is called as equatorial low pressure belt. Explain the Coriolis effect. The movement of air will change its direction due to the rotation of earth on its own axis is called as Coriolis effect. Due to this effect, the air will change its direction both in the northern and southern hemispheres. So this we discussed in today's class. Try to get answers for these questions and write down in a specific notebook. So with this we discussed the basic pressure belts and these all today. So with this I will conclude today's lesson. Thank you all for giving this opportunity.